If giving up a traditional residence to live year-round in a motorhome seems unrealistic, yet buying an RV only to hit the road on weekends also doesn't make sense, you may want to consider the comfortable middle ground known as part-time RVing. Martin and Gail are excellent examples of this option. These culinary professionals have successfully combined their city life, work life, and life off the grid to create the perfect recipe for their ideal RV experience.
So my name is Gail, and we've been RVing for 3 years, and this RV is the first one we've ever owned. So we went from zero, knowing absolutely nothing, to having a 40-footer. And it's been wonderful for us. Martin and I are not full-timers yet. We're looking at doing that next year. We're not planning to retire. We're planning to try a different environment and looking at different work. Right now, I work out of province. So I commute every week. I fly out Monday mornings, come back Friday nights. And I find that it's really, really so nice for me to get off an airplane. And this campground is only a 10-minute drive from the airport, which I think is amazing to come into this environment.
I love the color green. I absolutely love waking up here every single morning. And yes, it's a big fat pain with the long commute to get to work, but I would rather be here. And 6 months of the year, as much as I can, I live here on board this coach, because otherwise, it's very nice, but we have an apartment on the 14th floor of a building in Midtown Toronto. I've got a view of the lake, so I can sort of look out, see that, and I can watch the freighters sink. But on the other hand, this is nicer. I wake up every morning at 4:30 or 4:45 with birdsong and the beautiful dawn. And that's why I come here, as much as I possibly can.
Another appeal of part-timing is that wide-eyed excitement that never gets old. Martin and Gail always remember to relish their road trips and appreciate each stop, taking the time to enjoy every excursion like it's their first.
Our idea is not to drive long time every day. That's not what we do this for. We want to be able to have time to stop and just to enjoy the travel and enjoy the country, and not exactly kill ourselves doing it, you know. Otherwise, like, buy a plane and go have fun with that. But this is how we choose to travel, is that coach behind me. And it's called Tortoise for a reason. You know, it's slow when I drive it. It takes up a lot of space, and it kind of invites you to look around as you go slowly.
Their Itasca Horizon was specifically tailored with several upgrades to ensure safety and competence, particularly in the kitchen, where the fridge takes the cake.
We've done some major work on it. A lot of it's been cosmetic. For example, shag carpeting, who knew, was au courant in 2007. So the shag carpeting is gone. So we replaced all the carpeting. And we had to upgrade the fridge, because we have, or actually replaced the fridge. What's really important for us, because we do a lot of traveling and boondocking, is that it was really important for us to have a dual fridge. And it took a while to get it, because you have to order it, and it was a Dometic fridge. We had very particular specifications. We wanted to have the freezer, we wanted to have the dual propane and power, and we also wanted to make sure it was large enough for us, because of the fact that we do catering and we do the teaching from Skolpad Cooks. So we've replaced the fridge, we've replaced the carpeting, replaced the lighting too.
That we've changed all the lighting to LED, so that when we're boondocking, our batteries and everything last longer, and we don't have to turn on the generator. It's got a huge genset underneath, but that's not the point. So we want to be as independent as possible.
So whether you're full-timing or part-timing, just be sure to take your time and savor every moment.